What's up, y'all? I am Marcus, and welcome back to From the Dark. We are down in the entrance to the Dark Moon Tomb. We are going to go back up and do the Painted World today. Once again, we're using our Furious Spider build. We've got the Quelog's Fury Sword along with our Ascended Pyromancy Flame, Spider Shield, Crown of Dusk. Once again, I'm using the Invisible Texture mod for it. And Bellowing Dragoncrest Ring. So we've got a ton of firepower with our pyromancies. And let me show my stats here real quick. Remember to keep showing you guys those because I am doing stuff off camera. If you missed the end of the last episode, I highly recommend that you go back and check it out. We had a really, really, really cool moment. Like, it's just one of those little things that just happens in Dark Souls. But we also had a dialogue with Solaire. Where he talked about he was pondering his poor fortune, where he didn't find his son, not in An Orlando, nor in Twilight Blight Town. And he's saying, where else might his son be? Perhaps Lost Izalith or the Tomb of the Gravelord. And he's going to continue seeking his son. But there are a couple of parts of this dialogue that are just stupidly interesting, stupidly fascinating. The one that I always... have keyed in on in that dialogue was, I became undead to pursue this. Because he says, I became undead to pursue this. And it's one of those things, like, he makes it sound as if he became undead on purpose. And it's one of those things, because we don't know much about the nature of how one becomes undead, like, you know, we've talked about the possibilities of when you die and you are reborn, that's when you realize you're undead, but that doesn't always necessarily seem to be the case. Like, it doesn't quite add up. And we've got dialogues like Laurentius, like, the day I became undead, I was ecstatic. So he didn't seem to have any control over the process whatsoever. But beyond that, you know, there's this whole issue of, like, can you intentionally become undead? There's that going on. But it always led me to kind of not pay enough attention to another part of that dialogue. He says, when I peer up at the sun above, it occurs to me, what if I'm seen as a laughingstock, as a blind fool without reason? As a blind fool without reason. Lord Gwyn's firstborn was a god of war, but his foolishness led to a loss of the annals. Funny that Solaire is, you know, he's wondering if the gods above see him as a fool. That's a major concern. Alright, well, I mean, I guess if you like it like that, but, you know, I'm just not interested, dude. Damn, these sexual fucking death poses. All right. I guess my mind's in the gutter to get today, guys. We want to get a good look at this, so let's kill these guys. Oh, that was slick. Look at Slick Rick here. God damn. I need to fucking chill out, don't I? Okay. I want to get a better look at that painting before we pull a Ghostbusters. We ruined that chandelier, man. It's not the first chandelier that I've ruined. Hey! Damn delay. The input delay in Dark Souls can sometimes be a pain in the butt. Most of the time you can work around it. Looking good. Painted World of Ariamis. Sweet. Alright. Let's do it. We can only interact with this once again because we have the peculiar doll. A strange doll in strange dress. There once was an abomination who had no place in this world. She clutched this doll tightly and eventually was drawn into a cold and lonely painted world. And this gives us the painted world of Ariamis. Or however you want to say it. Like, whatever. Can't go back. That dog don't hunt. See the water down below. This wasn't technically the first area made for Dark Souls, but an area similar to this that this was based on was the first area made for the prototype, and they put so much hour this puts so you could really in a lot of ways say this was the first area, and since they put so much time and effort into this, they really wanted to use it in the game. And this is all from the Design Works interview. Miyazaki-san said, "God damn, that sucks, y'all. Oh man, jeez." Miyazaki-san said, you know, they put so much effort into it and they liked the design so much they really wanted to use it in the game, but it didn't really fit in. So in the end, he kind of cheated a little bit and put it in this kind of like separate reality. I don't mind him cheating on this point because this is a really cool place. It's got a very, very fun atmosphere to it. Now, the thing about the painted world, though, is we cannot leave until we finish it at this point. So we best just get started. You're going to see lots of crow or raven imagery as we proceed. But kind of a fascinating point about this is that, to me, this whole area is kind of the area of, there's a lot of reused ideas here. There are ideas reused here that came from Demon Souls, where you can see how that, how Demon Souls influenced the Dark Souls project. But beyond that, there are ideas that would be reused in Dark Souls 2 and Bloodborne as well. Like, for example, the idea of a corpse hanging from a chain or something like that, suspended high above. First of all, those that you can cut down. This is an idea that we find quite a bit. Oops. Oh, come on. I might not get it. Fine, I'll do it melee. I could have just used a bow, I know, but we're going to be using those throwing knives later as well. Speaking of bows. The hollows here hit kind of hard. These guys. That when they die, they spew out a bunch of toxin. We won't have to deal with that toxin because our sword does fire damage, and if you kill them with a fire attack, it burns up the toxin. It doesn't spray out. And this is another one of those reused ideas as well, because in Bloodborne, actually, the silver beasts that you fight in Nightmare Mensis, yeah, they, if you kill them with fire attack, their little worms don't pop out, right? If I'm remembering correct. Ugh, frame rate issues. The Dark Souls 1 PC port, very poorly optimized. It was one of those things when the petition first came out to bring Dark Souls 1 specifically to PC. I loved the idea of it being on PC, of the Souls series being on PC, but I thought Dark Souls 1 was a poor choice. I thought it should start from Dark Souls 2 because the port was going to be so poorly optimized. Now, in the end, I think it's been for the best because a lot of people who otherwise would not have been able to get in on this wonderful game have been able to, but still, I think there was still a lot of wisdom in what I was saying at the time. I was like, look, FromSoft is not known for doing a good job with this kind of, like, with PC games in general, and this port's gonna be maybe not what a lot of people are hoping it would be. You see the crow people, and I'm gonna go ahead and call them the crow people of Velka, because once again in the Design Works interview, Miyazaki-san talked about how the original concept for these are followers of Velka who were so devoted that they actually became twisted and deformed. Now, why would they become crow-like creatures? Why specifically crow people? Well, oh no. Hey. Just trying to trigger that, but I walked a little too far. Who knows? The shadow knows. All right, I got the soul of Proud Knight. Hey. There we are. You are not prepared, but I am. I am most certainly prepared. We got a pretty good setup for this area, and now we see. I like how this. I like how the snow actually does here. How it kind of thins out. It's awesome. It's really cool. It's really cool. Fried finger. Could see more crow people, and then the guy patrolling along the way. This area really set the tone for Dark Souls for the development team. Like they wanted to make sure that what they put in here really kind of encapsulated the spirit of what Dark Souls was going to be. Like all of the elements. I gotta say, I think they did a fantastic job with that. Soul of a brave warrior. Soul of a dumb hollow. Soul of a dumb motherfucker that done stepped up in a wrong place. Alright. And this spits us right back out where we were. Looking over here. Make sure I don't forget anything. I don't think we can quite get there just yet. Yeah, we'll have to walk over there in a bit. Pretty sure we can get to the... Ah, well, I'll just shoot it down. Why not? It doesn't even matter which bow we use. And we can just use a wooden arrow because... Whatever. And Pyro Flame. Which you can two-hand. Doesn't really help you at all, but you can do it. Humanity. I was just looking at this little, like, bridgeway over here. It just was reminding me of Sin's Fortress, of the way that you get to the room that has Tarkus in it. Like, I mean, it's completely unrelated. It reminded me of it, you know what I'm saying? That's enough of that. We got a sniper situation here. Here you can see how arrows actually curve. Like from when he shoots it, and then I take a step, and you actually see the arrow adjust to be able to hit me. Like, he shoots it. If I stand here and don't move, it's going to be there. But if I actually move as soon as he shoots it, it's going to curve and hit me. It's ridiculous. This game is ridiculous. That fireball's a bigger issue. I'm not sure, but the Crown of Dusk is probably affecting us in the amount of damage that we received from that. Oh shit, that was close. I almost didn't block it at all. That would have hurt. Plus, I think this shield doesn't necessarily have super fire defense. That was a lot of killing. Fuck you, table. Oh, I forgot I don't have a kick. I got a sweet backflip. Let's see. There it is. Jerks. You're clipping a little bit there, buddy. See if we can't help him out. Popped straight up. Because of the fire animation, he popped straight up. That was funny stuff. Can hop down over there. And actually, you can. God, these frame rates are pissing me off. I have a pretty damn decent computer, guys. So the fact that I drop frames on this game is really, really irritating. You actually can make this jump. I can't remember if it was Steez or if it was Phil Old that showed that to me. Watch it be a third person and me just completely misremembering. But yeah, you actually can make that jump. I thought that maybe you could, and I tried for a while. But yeah, it is entirely possible to get to that. And I think that the ninja roll actually helps you get there easier. But as you can see, there is an alternate path. And that's what I'm going to use. But just kind of one of those like little details of the game that's been discovered through the years, and not by me, mind you. I speculated that you could make that. I'm like, it really looks like you can make that jump, but I never did make it. And we can see there's going to be another way to get to that. In fact, this room, it's got a lot of like, you come in through this door right here, right? And you're dealing with the archer sniper and then the fire sniper over there. If you go down here to deal with the fire sniper, as you saw, all those guys drop down from above and you've got a little clusterfuck going there. Damn, frame rates. You come over here, deal with the archer, and then you got these little guys. You can see a treasure, you can jump down here. That's one exit. Back the way you came is two. There's this door is three. Come around here. You got four going upstairs and five going this way. This room is crazy. Like, just in the amount of shit that there is. Of course, you get out here and it's just this, but it's very easy to miss that one little thing because you're busy with other stuff. I could just imagine the frost on the wood there. They do a really good job of getting across the atmosphere. So even if you explore, ultimately, really only a couple of ways you want to go forward. More ambushers. And let me see if we can actually... No, we can't see from here. I was wondering if we could see some hanging off that bridge over there. Would have been really slick. This is the tower that we saw from the beginning of the level. From over yonder way. But first, let's see. Actually, I'm not sure if we maybe we should deal with these. Yeah, we should deal with the followers of Velka first. If I can lure a couple of them. There you are. But can you find your way to me? I can find my way to you. Yeah, great combustion with the bellowing and also Dusk. That is absolutely the way to handle them, ladies. Speaking of reused, yeah, similar model to Ornifex. Might be the exact same model? I don't think it's... Maybe they've changed it a little bit, but... A very similar model to Ornifex from Dark Souls 2. Gotta get to that another way. Alright. I guess let's deal with this dragon and then open up the area shortcut. Did you guys see that? I think... What the... No! And he goes to breathe in his poison. Oh shit, I can't see. Come on, there you go. Ah! I dislike fighting this guy in melee because of the lingering hitbox of the poison and because of how easy it is to get your angle all messed up by his head bumping into you. But fortunately, the easy way... Might as well just use wood arrows too, because it don't make no difference. Ain't like he's moving around a lot. Sit here and shoot him in the empty eye socket. He's got really good vision for somebody who can't see. That's really weird. It seems like every other arrow is not actually hitting him. That's fascinating. Hold on. Is it just not showing up and still doing damage? Hold on, let me watch the bar. Maybe the bar is just not showing up. Either way. Your life is now over. And as per usual, we get a dragon scale out of that shit. Also a large soul of a proud knight, and further up the bridge, the blood shield. Very cool, very unique shield. The blood blood shield spoken of in the Lost Legends. The red of blood is slightly enchanted and boosts various resistances. Was this a community shield? I can't remember. I think this was a designed by community shield. Either way, this can block against... I know it can block against poison. I think it can block against bleed as well. If I recall correctly, we'll test it out here in a bit. The Lost Legends. You mean the Lost Annals? Oh, it does boost all of your resistances. There's that aspect to it. Hold on. Like, literally, your resistances. Maybe that's what I'm remembering. But I think it also has the special block poison effect when you're blocking with it and block an attack that can cause poison. I don't think it causes any bleed. I mean, any buildup. I'm not sure. I need to check it. Let's rock that bad boy. Shit. It actually goes with what we got kicking here. That works for me. This is by far the sneakiest shortcut in the game. You got this ripped up bottom half of a undead dragon, right? And no matter how often you hit it, no matter how much damage you deal, you ain't gonna hurt this thing, man. But all you have to do, jumping R2 and it stands straight up. You would think that it's a glitch or a bug, but they haven't taken it out years later. This has been known about forever since the game originally came out. Probably before that, I feel like testers found it if it wasn't intentional in the first place. And I think it was intentional in the first place because it's a perfect little shortcut. It's just too fucking convenient. It's just too fucking convenient to have that work that way. But beyond that, it's funny. And as we've discussed before, FromSoft, they've got a weird sense of humor that I dig. That I really, really dig. So, yeah. I'm gonna go ahead and say that that is intentional. I think that's something that they did on purpose. Alright, now let's open up this little shortcut. Down here, any crows want to come down and fuck with me? I got great combustion for your ass. Come on. I guess one thing I should point out too is we got a locked by some contraption door here, as well as this fog gate. Traverse the white light. Make sure nobody gonna fall down behind me, cause that ain't gonna be a good time. And here we have yet another idea reused from Demon Souls. Fallings. Ugh. Shit. Shit. They hit harder than I remember. They spreading out too. Ring of Sacrifice. I think that might actually have been one of the items that I was looking down at earlier. Maybe not. That item came from... Yeah, it was. This item came from above where we cut the rope or chain that was holding it and it fell down here. Okay. Wow. That ain't no good. That's better. That's much, much better. If you guys haven't played Demon's Souls, then you might not understand why this is such a... like, obvious... like, this is from Demon's Souls. Oh shit, these enemies are. Oh. Didn't have time to finish collecting the item before he threw his spear at me. That. Can't really see either. Hey. Come on, I only got one more. Eh. Burn. Damn, I got hit by another one. These guys are buttholes. All right. I got a lot of HP too. Fortunately, very, very weak against fire. But yeah, the basic concept behind this enemy is absolutely something from a boss in Demon Souls. We can collect a bunch of spears and large leather shields if we want. Fascinating, this is a graveyard. I never really paid attention to that point. I mean, it makes sense. It seems as though this was a Church of Velka. Like this area, the painted world, it seems to me like a cathedral or a Church of Velka. One that's been destroyed. And I'm, through the years I've wondered, and I'm kind of at the point, my current belief is that this is a statue of Velka with Priscilla. And Priscilla may in fact be her daughter. This is, I'm beginning to believe at this point in time that Velka may actually be Priscilla's mother. And Seath may in fact be the father, not sure. We've opened up the shortcut at the very least, and that hollow scared the crap out of me. Fortunately, I got iframes from opening the door. Aw, I was late. And that, wow, okay. Controller, please, cooperate. Go ahead and kill these fellas over here. Oh! Thought that was gonna finish you off. And collect these items. But we need to come back over here when we're in human form in order to face an enemy phantom, an invader. Proud knight. Proud knight. Let's see. Large soul of a proud knight. These little prison cells are just like frightening, right? They got wheels on the bottom to be rolled around. Looks like for transporting prisoners, which makes sense if this is a Church of Velka, you know, transporting the guilty. She's the goddess of sin and punishment. Makes a lot of sense, actually. If the undead truly do resurrect forever, and these hollows are, they just resurrect right there on the pole, maybe. Hopefully they're going back to their bonfire. But the crow's keeping watch over them. Nasty stuff. Maybe that's what they do with the undead body here. After the undead spirit is gone, back to the bonfire. Pyromancy acid surge. Pyromancy 4 into the Great Swamp. Emit acid which corrodes weapons and armor. Not all pyromancy originates in the Great Swamp. One hears rumors of unknown pyromancers inhabiting various lands, and this spell is the work of one such outlander. And the poison mist was kind of a heretical pyromancy, and acid surge, I think you might look at it the same way. Maybe it's considered an abomination that shouldn't exist. Maybe it gets stashed in the painted world. Or maybe not. We see you there, buddy. And you. And you. And here's where we could have just cut it down in melee, because this is the beginning. This is the entrance. Good deal. I love the painted world. This is just one of the slickest areas, you know? Wait, did I let myself get turned around? Alright, here's the courtyard. And here's the steeple. There's the church and there's the people! Something fucked up about that here in this area. Yeah, this leads us down below. We'll handle that in a bit. Oops, something fell to its death. Painted world just full of stuff to explore, really. It's locked. Yeah, totally a church. I would love to see this place before it's destroyed. I would love to see this as a church of, assuming it is a church of Elka, because that's just my opinion on it, but if this was a church of Elka, I would love to see this place before it was all destroyed, and hopefully without hollows impaled on spikes everywhere, and to kind of see what sort of, what was going on before all of this. That would be really, really cool. Alright, now, a very Castlevania, very reminiscent of Castlevania to me for some reason. Ooh, there you go. That's a grab attack. That's kind of hard to dodge here. Oh, there we go. Kind of hard to dodge on the stairs, so it's better if you can bait them to a place where you can move to the side a little bit. Is that it? Did the other one already fall down before? Oh no, here she comes. Really awesome place for a fight or a duel of sorts. Come on, boo. Atta girl. Ooh, that fallen attack. That plunging attack, man. I plunged down from the plank. If you don't know what that's a reference to, you'll know soon enough. Love the view here. Love it. Love it! Awesome. Red sign, soapstone. Be summoned to another world as dark spirit and defeat the summoner to acquire humanity. Certain dark wraiths resist their descent into dark and persevere along the honorable path. The red sign, soapstone is for them. So, a dark wraith that wants to collect humanity from other undead, but only if they're willing to challenge them, only if it's in a duel. They're not trying to invade and murder. They're trying to win honorable blood duels. This fucking game, man! I love this, just... Man. Let's see. Okay, we can see the containers in the prison yard, and actually, those phalanx almost. No, I don't know. I wonder how many of these hollows are I wonder if these hollows are, like, a lot of them are hollowed followers of Velka who were intended to protect the church, and more specifically protect Priscilla, and based off some dialogue that we'll get from her, I wonder if that's the case. Which would explain why they attack you, and explain why she says they're gentle. And I say that too because the phalanx looks like it's kind of an amalgamation of multiple hollows put together. And it's very much seems to be protecting the statue of Velka and Priscilla. If, once again, if that's a statue of Velka, that's just my basic assumption for this area. Although it seems to be a very logical one, particularly given Miyazaki's comments about the crow people being followers of Velka that were so devoted that they actually transformed into to be more like crows. Did I already go underneath it? Yeah, it's over. It's up just a little bit above. One more treasure we want to pick up here. Soul of a brave warrior. And now when you fall down here, we can see that there's something out there as well. Let's see. Can I just... I'm trying to remember... I might have to get to that with the annex key now that I think about it. Yeah, I think that's exactly how you get there. Cool that you can see it. Just teasing you, just out of your reach. This shortcut, by the way, it bypasses so much. There's so much of this level left that we haven't done yet, but... Down here in this courtyard, there is a well. A well? What is it? It's a well. Sorry. I'm gonna go ahead and swap to a more stable shield, though, because there's some asshole shit up in here, y'all. Ooh. We should probably rest at a bonfire and get some great combustions back. Matter of fact, I think that's exactly what we'll do. Because as you can see, bone wheel skeleton assholes. Ah, fuck it. That's not suspicious at all. Fascinating too that this is the same damn fake looking wall that is in Sin's Fortress. It doesn't look as out of place in Sin's Fortress. But if you realize here that it's... Oh, fuck. I broke the wrong one and walked forward to boot. Oh, I'm fucked. God. Damn it. Oh, shit. I knew that was gonna happen. But if you see the ones here and you break them... and you realize, oh, it's just a fake fucking wall right there, then it might lead you to discovering the ones in Sin's Fortress as well. Shit. Where's my damn... We're gonna equip a ring of sacrifice. Guys, I'm Marcus, also known as EMB. We'll pick back up next time, because it's already running a little bit long, and I got some stuff I gotta get done. I will catch you guys on the next From the Dark. We'll finish up the Painted World. We're probably going to take out Super Londo Bros. And then, man, we are going to be halfway done with the game. Later, y'all.